Welcome to Magic Gathering Strat. I'm Dan. This is Power T's revision of Azorius Kitty, as detailed in Competitive Podcast episode 17, and my own article on Pure MTGO today. It isn't live yet, but it will be very shortly. I'm gonna play a random game, cause I have no buddies online. If you want to be on this buddy list, tell me your Magic Online username and what decks you have ready. I know there are people I should have put on the list. They are in the notepad document, as Magic Online wasn't available to me at the time. But I can do administration now, or I can actually get a video done. So I'm gonna play in the tournament practice room. We are playing Pauper. Pauper. Best 2 out of 3. Yoo-hoo! I am 3-1 with Azorius Kitty now, I think. Let me check that. While we wait. Yes, 3-1. Sorry, I checked again. It's 4-1. And here's an opponent. Chris Amakasa. Oh no, I have the magic sounds on. It's a new computer. Gotta get rid of those. Gameplay. Display and sound effects volume. Just die, all of them. Okay, this is not the mulligan. Identify this immediately. This is a pretty new account. I have only played a few matches on it. Well, then I have to perform, right? Crossroads. Familiar. And then go do great things. That's my plan. He took a mulligan. Ooh! This, I have been told, is an extremely easy matchup. Let's see what we can do. No way to abuse the Sunscape Familiar right now. But there is one. He's gonna be powered. I need a way to wreck his lands. So I need to draw a ton of cards, pretty much. That's what I need to do. Find reality acids, do great things with them. Lone Missionary and Deep Analysis are the bad cards in this matchup. But on the other hand, taking 3 damage is not very dangerous against him. He has the Tron on turn 3, just as he's supposed to. He's gonna cast a Fangrim Marauder, which is not dangerous for me at all. No, he's gonna cast a Muldrifter, that's a bit worse. Still not too scary. We draw cards. Spreading Seas is fantastic, isn't it? So we're Spreading Seas the tower. And we pretty much need more blue mana, right? Journeying the Muldrifter, is there a point to that? Not really, I think I'm gonna play the Chancer here. And return the Crossroads. Throw away a Crossroads. Maybe a Missionary. He had another tower. That will get him to 8. So maybe I should not have thrown away the lone missionary, because his endgame is dependent on getting stuff more broken than that into play. So, spreading seas on the tower. Mulldrifter. Seems like a decent idea. Then I can block the Fangrim Marauder. Or should I just get rid of it? I should, shouldn't I? Let's preordain. Taking the preordain. Yeah, casting the Journey to Nowhere. And play the Chancery. Looks good to me. Next tower. My god. Why didn't he attack? Your name? Where are my reality acids? Top, bottom. Play it. And play a 3-mana Mulldrifter. Seems like a decent plan. And there we go! Mr. Reality Acid! Now there will be a party. But he still has 9 mana and all the colors in the world. Ancient Starrings! I hope sound is okay here, it's a new setup. I did the Top 10 Magic podcast last night with this setup, but yeah, I hope it works. I'm using Camtasia again. Yes. Well, no more tower for him very soon. With 2 Sunscape Familiars, it costs me just 2 mana to destroy land. So I can destroy 2 lands, and I should probably focus on that, right? Unblock his Mulldrifter if necessary. Use the Drake Familiar so I can bounce my own Mulldrifter. Yes, but it's definitely land destruction at this point. Unless he plays something that is actually dangerous. I smell another... No, no Fangrim Marauder. 4 mana for what? Another Seagate Oracle, but yeah, they don't matter. I matter! Oh, sorry, just slipped out of me. Alright, so we do cast Reality Acid on the tower. We do cast the Drake Familiar. Returning Reality Acid. Cast. Oh no, we really needed something white to do with the mana. They called it a Tron and I just turned it off. Can't do much else. I think that was the right play. Just wreck his mana base. Just keep going on that note. Because he still has 5 mana. That's enough for a Muldrifter. That's not okay. Here's something red is happening. It's a Firebolt. For my poor Sunscape familiar. What? No, a Lightning Bolt. Interesting. What? Why are you doing this? I'm blocking. And maybe blocking. Then he can firebolt the other Sunscape familiar. But he didn't. And I finally get something to do with my white mana. Well, let's start doing damage then. Preordain. Spreading Seas, not the crossroads. White mana. Spreading Seas. Sunscape familiar. That was a badly played turn. I sense. So I'm not sure exactly how, but oh, there's a mountain. All right, yeah, I think that was correct. Reprisal, reprisal. Two Hydroblast. One relic. We take out 3 lone missionaries. I guess we keep one to do broken stuff with if we need life. Deep Analysis leaves us, which is surprising, and one journey. This is hard to keep. Mulligan to 6. This is also hard to keep. And we mulligan to 5. And that we keep. Now we are in trouble. Maybe some of the time he doesn't get Tron on turn 3. But now I get the Sorcery's Chancery, which sort of helps me with the mulligan. Though I'm now flooding instead. Oh, he's gonna get it on turn 3, isn't he? Power plant, do it. Turning on the Tron. Yeah, of course. But then nothing. Which I remember happening a lot with that deck. Sunscape familiar seems like a good idea here. And then maybe a real Muldrifter next turn. And then Sunscape familiar, another real Muldrifter. Yeah, because if I play the Sunscape familiar, I can evoke both Muldrifters. Oh, that hurt. So bad, actually. Good old Stone Rain. I have to evoke here, right? I think I do. To draw myself out of this misery. He missed the land drop as well, though. He is having a clunky draw. But he has ways to correct that. So, for something to happen, I have to evoke again here. But is that really what I want to do? I can't spend a turn doing nothing, can I? Oh, I think I have to evoke again. Yeah. Hopefully finding white mana here. But I found Mr. Hydroblast. That could be useful. Oracles, familiars, all kind of useless guys on the battlefield. But will he draw into something significant? He has all the mana in the world. Hydroblast! Whoa, Reality Acid Drake Familiar seems like a play for the tower or the mine. I haven't seen him fetch anything, have I? So I think this must be the right play. The Tron is turned off. For now. So we are going for towers as usual. There is an expedition map. But he cannot use it yet. Though he has that thing. And he's going for the tower, so then I should switch my target to mines, probably. Preordain or Maldrifter. If I drifter, I have no chance to Reality Acid. But my chance to Reality Acid is pretty slim anyway. But if I find a white man, I can do it? Can I? Yes, I can. Or Drake Familiar. And I find Spreading Seas, which probably will serve me quite well here. So Spreading Seas the mine. Throwing into my other Spreading Seas. Can cast... Hey! Yes! Sorry, I'm thinking like an idiot. Do I save this now? For his tower. And now I'm tempted to evoke the Maldrifter again. I don't want to cast the Reality Acid really either. Okay, we evoke the Maldrifter. And we find nothing. Swing for two. So now we need both the mine and tower. And that tower is mine. But he has 5 mana, so he can cast the Maldrifter. Or Rolling Thunder, which will set me back somewhat. Spreading Seas on the tower. Tron is now far away. Here is some white mana. And the relic then. Nothing of interest there. Should I just burn it? No, not yet. Do I have cards in my graveyard that I care for? No. Why didn't I attack? Very questionable. Okay, just breathe deeply, think. There's another tower, which must be destroyed. Damn it, I want my card. And he brought a mine as well. So, here we go. Well, let's destroy the tower then. Default plan, tower. Let's attack first. This time we're not gonna forget it. I do have a Sunscape Familiar. But I can't play both. I have two Sunscape. No, I want that tower dead. Now. So much white. I'm not really afraid of anything he has. He can't burn me. I have removal for everything. So what can he do? How does he get out of this? Just by outdrawing me. He must draw just Muldrifters and Seagate Oracles. It seems that this matchup is indeed favored for Azorius Kitty. The other Thunder! So the Thunders are now gone! And he has to win the hard way. Well, Sunscape Familiar will do a lot of work here. And he might have a round of Tron, but I don't fear anything now, because the Thunders are gone. Though he could play a wall. I don't really understand why Mnemonic Wall has fallen out of favor so much. But I still don't discount the possibility that he might play it. Okay, I want him to play creatures now. I am unsure if I should have taken out Deep Analysis for one of these removal spells. Stone Rain. That's something to fear. Well, that was a very exciting turn, wasn't it? Yeah, my thing is gonna get you. I'm talking about the reality asset. Uh-oh. Yeah, you play at my game. Okay, I don't want a white card now. No white card, please. A white card! He still hasn't found the tower he needed. But if he does find the tower now, he'll have a ton of mana, but he doesn't have any cards. I feel quite comfortable here, actually. No idea why he doesn't play Earth Rift or Stone Rain, but he wants the speed, I assume. Maybe he's playing Earth Rift 2! And there we kill the mine with the slowest Stone Rain in the world. Well, if he now plays a giant creature, which he can do, as he does have the mana, I don't have any white mana to defend myself with, so I will lose. And here comes Crusher. Ooh, well, a Plains would be nice. That works. Actually, incredibly well. I'm prepared to take a hit from you. Throw away Journey to Nowhere here will sort of give away the game. Well, I do think I sacrificed two islands, and I'm comfortable with that. Don't get your hopes up. Well, he can... he can use his Haunted Fangraph here and cast the Crusher again next turn, but I don't really care too much about that, so I can just destroy it again. So I should perhaps have used Journey to Nowhere, but then he could have destroyed the Journey to Nowhere at the end of my turn, so I prefer to have that thing dead and gone. So let's try to do that again. Let's first pre-arrange. Drake Familiar. We don't want this Crossroads, do we? And now we have to reprisal it again. And playing that for a Spreading Seas. Is that good enough? No, I don't. I want to play it for the Realty Acid after I play the Sunscape Familiar. So I'm done. What a weird game. He had a second one. I predict a Seagate Orc. Oh, it's an expedition map. For what? For a tower, surprisingly. Which is not played. So let's wreck his hope by killing stuff. The mine. And continue the Drake Familiar beatdown of yore. Though Ulamog's Crusher can return this turn. But that tower is going to die. Unless Ulamog's Crusher return, in which case I can't kill the tower. Life is full of choices. Life is like a box of hand grenades. Sooner or later, everything blows up. Oh, I sideboard out my deep analysis, and he sideboards it in. I don't want to sideboard out my deep analysis. I liked it. That guy. I don't like that guy. Luckily, my Skyfisher will outclass him. Oh, he was just evoked. Sweet. shows that I have total control of what's going on here. Well, kill the Ursulans. Always good. Keeping him at 8 mana, like the land destruction deck I am. No, I'm not gonna leave this out there. It doesn't have a really good target, does it? Is it Mr. Crusher? No, you don't have mana for Mr. Crusher. No! My god, how many stone rains do you have? Judge! I think that was all four of the stone rains. But let's... there's one, yeah, and three in the graveyard. Is that right? Yes. I'm gonna deck him, probably. That's pretty embarrassing. Core Sky Fisher is now dead. Dead, dead, dead. He doesn't have anything worth destroying, really. So I do want to wait with this and this for the next land he plays. So I guess I just beat down with the Drake Familiar, even though it feels pretty inconclusive. Sixteen cards left. No, none of the failing Ursulans. Missing Ursulans. He could, if he has like enchantment removal, he could free his lands. Which would be a problem. I do want to retrieve the Spreading Seas and cast them again, but that is probably way too greedy. Oh, he's going for the Muldrifter, getting closer to the mill death. Still evoking it. But you have seven lands, so you should be able to do something. You should be able to do a lot if you have 13 business spells left. Like cast a lightning bolt. Chancery, well, let's take a Chancery and cast it. I know you have the Crusher in your hand. But do you have a way to protect it? Does he have a way to get his cards back? I don't think he does. I'm gonna deck him. Or he's gonna deck himself. 10 cards left. And he got a Chromatic Star. Which doesn't seem very useful. Do this. Cast a Mr. Maldriftar, Maladriftar. And begin the flyer beatdown again. Get back a Spreading Sea seems incredibly dangerous. So we are not going to do that. We can actually get back the Maldrifter. We have 20 cards, he has 10. So I think it should be okay. comes the crusher. Well, his hopes are instantly crushed. Thank you for watching. Shout out to you, Chris Samakase, for being a good opponent. And I think I'm playing more games with this deck, because it is a lot of fun. Crazy grind. I played against Chris Amakasi, who was playing Rogue Tron. I just won 2-0. And I'm now 5-1 with Azorius Kitty 2.0, or all Azorius Kitty decks really. Thank you for watching. Cheers.